Namaskara, my dear ladies and gentlemen. How are you doing today? Welcome to a presentation on doHow for execution excellence. I will start with my background and an introduction to what we have been doing, present the 1% inspiration and 99% perspiration, share some case studies on how we address these challenges for the 99% perspiration, and then answer how, what, and why we are helping manufacturing companies, and lastly, share our value proposition. After an enriching corporate career of 26 years with Bosch, a German multinational world-class company, I started Samuthana in 2013 for creating exceptional leaders and world-class companies. We've been helping various companies, mostly manufacturing, for improving their performance in the various areas of business using doHow, a Socratic methodology developed by me for execution excellence. One of our multinational clients improved the inventory turn ratio by 1.5 points in 3 months. We inspired them by creating a segmented sourcing strategy based on sourcing location, packaging condition, inventory classification, and the product type. This is normally an easy one. The real challenge is in implementing this strategy, especially in our ecosystem with a rather low maturity in manufacturing excellence. So much needed for execution excellence. Working with various industries such as aerospace, construction, corporate gifting, electronic manufacturing systems, sustainable products, machine tools, solar power, tool holders, tier 1 and tier 2 companies for tractors, commercial vehicles, cars, prefab buildings, non-ferrous castings, books, energy equipment, fast-moving consumer goods, aluminium extrusions, tier 1 companies for two-wheelers, high-precision gears, and high-productive tools, we keep encountering these 99% perspiration challenges. Common understanding of the stakeholder expectations and current reality, inclusive strategy development, strategy detailing, and execution planning with a buffer, regular monitoring and reviewing for consistently meeting the targets, and problem solving, and last but not the least, one-on-one and group dialogues. Let me now share some case studies on common understanding. I've developed a concept I call business chakras, analogical to the 7 chakras in our human bodies, for identifying the weak link in the business. The first 2 chakras address market-to-market flow, the next 2, the people-to-people flow, and the last 2, standards-to-standards flow, with the 7th chakra addressing the mindset and culture within the organization. Of course, you can check out my videos to understand more about business chakras or read some of my blogs on business chakras to get to know them better. The key players in this company identified that cash flow is the weakest link as they assessed the chakra maturity individually. And then when they discussed along with evidence in teams of 2, 3, or 4, the weakest link turned out to be the top-down chakra, basically involving the primary role of leadership to bring in clarity in the job roles and deliverables. This aha experience got the leadership team taking the ownership for the outcomes. Though it sounds ridiculous, that's the reality. Welcome to the true world. With another client, the market canvas assessment, considering the lower absolute scores and the increasing variances, showed that the marketing team's awareness of the comparison segment 3, which really is a blue ocean market, was rather low. This insight led them to start regular market information sharing on this particular segment in the marketing team so that they could achieve a good amount of revenue growth. The comprehensive business health check of a small company led to implementing the doHow smart, lean performance management system. We do the inclusive strategy development with as many key players as necessary, with diverse perceptions and opinions, using our doHow inspirational persuasion game, which brings out all the ideas through the alternating individual tasks and iteratively refines them to conclude on the strategies with consensus through the alternating collective tasks. In this case of a large FMCG company, their team improved sales playing the doHow game face to face every fortnight for 2 hours. In the case of a multinational high complexity manufacturing company, their team achieved 100% customer on time in full deliveries playing the doHow game, this time virtually every fortnight for 2 hours. In the case of a multinational EPC company in the energy sector, their team achieved an all-time record financial performance playing the doHow game face-to-face, this time for about 11 hours every day for 3 consecutive days over a weekend. In another case of a small company, their team achieved 25% year-on-year growth and improved profitability playing the doHow game face-to-face every week for about 1 hour. The execution planning is the next focus area which we have been working on. Our value addition is mainly in defining the way buffer needs to be embedded in the plan for the plan to be realistic and to consistently succeed. Since every plan is uniquely different, depends on the context, which is again unique, company and team, which are also unique. We then create rolling plans which serve as the lyrics in a karaoke event or the musical notes sheets used in the symphonic orchestra, which sounds phenomenal with so many people playing simultaneously as per the notes. With another client, we mentored the team in creating execution plans. Not only did the teams surpass the targets, but also became more confident to accept tougher targets. You must have found the slides rather colorful for a corporate presentation. Let me explain the reason behind this. doHow is designed for changing mindset and culture. In my understanding, our brain captures all our experiences and their emotions as memories. Some nice, some neutral, and some ugly. Based on these memories, our brain develops a unique framework or mindset as usually known. Mindset is the source for the real-time predictions done by our subconscious mind about 500 milliseconds in advance for preparing our response. While our conscious mind comes to know only 200 milliseconds before the response. Our mindset, which drives these predictions, defines the way we are perceiving the reality, enables thinking, stimulates deciding, and drives acting or responding. Always in relation to the predictions. Culture, on the other hand, is collective mindset. For example, of teams comprising of people with unique mindsets. Even teams collectively develop a unique framework or mindset which leads to collective predictions and behaviors. Discussions and debates on relevant topics in an environment conducive for free thinking creates the necessary emotional experiences for changing the individual mindset and the team culture. This, my dear ladies and gentlemen, is the core of doHow. Now I will show some examples of monitoring and reviewing we have been doing using our doHow app, which I'll explain briefly later, for improving productivity and reducing rejections, for improving adherence to the good practices, for improving the overall equipment effectiveness. Finally, coming to the problem solving and dialogue using our flow maturity model, a client achieved benchmark levels for the defects by improving at least 50%. Another client used our problem solving analysis module to narrow down the problem and identify the right causes for killing the problem. Another client improved the workflow with our process mapping modules again in the app. Line balancing for introducing production cells with a rhythmic flow along with an improvement in productivity of more than 50% was the outcome with another client. Our doHow dialogues module guided the leaders of another client to have a dialogue with their people and get them inspired for creating a proactive culture with accountability. Our doHow scoreboard naturally persuades the team to practice their insights, enabling our clients to overcome these 99 perspiration challenges. These 99 perspiration challenges are the foundation of our doHow smart lean performance system for execution excellence, enabled by our doHow app. The doHow app is used for creating transparency and remote monitoring in between the fortnightly face-to-face or virtual sessions to discuss the real-time scoreboards before introducing the next module in one of these five challenges that I have presented earlier. For improving execution, the most common challenge. We are creating execution excellence with our doHow. How are you creating execution excellence? By working on these basics. It's that simple. Please do get in touch with us for a discussion. Maybe it doesn't lead to anything, but at least both of us get to know each other. Looking forward to hearing from you.